Since February, 20 Tulsa traffic officers have been using the new e-ticket system. Those officers are writing tickets faster than ever, but the system is creating some problems for other city departments. Only on 2. 2 News reporter Casey Roebuck joins us with the details. Casey?
Well, Karen, by now about half of Tulsa's traffic citations are electronic. While the technology is great for officers, the municipal court system and prosecutor's office are overwhelmed.
I got you speeding this construction zone.
TPD's traffic unit is more efficient than ever thanks to electronic citations or e-tickets.
Okay, I'll be right back with you. Makes the citation process go a little faster, which helps the violator so they're not waiting on us so long. And also, it's a safety issue for the officer. The faster we get in and out of there, the less likely we are to be involved in an accident.
Officers scan driver's licenses, enter in the information, and then print out the ticket. Since February, more than 13,000 of Tulsa's 27,000 traffic citations have been electronic. But in order for any citation to be valid, it must be individually approved by a city prosecutor. Due to layoffs and retirements, Chief Prosecutor Bob Garner is one of only three city prosecutors who can approve them. With more tickets coming across his desk and his computer, Garner says it's getting tough to keep up.
For the bulk of the traffic tickets, you can do a lot of that review while you're in the courtroom. With the e-citation, we can't do that because you have to be at a computer.
It's the same story at the municipal courts building, where these ladies spend most of their time scanning paper copies of the e-citations, entering them into the court system's computer system, and then cutting out the e-tickets by hand, all because the e-ticket software is not yet compatible with the court system software.
It's taking quite a bit of time, and I don't have the personnel to do that because we, in turn, have lost personnel.
Municipal Courts Administrator Tony Salino says that upgrade can't come soon enough because it would cut his staff's workload by 90% and allow them to focus on other duties.
I know it'll greatly help us.
And the system administrator says layoffs in the city's IT department are to blame for the delay. He hopes to have an additional 400 officers using e-tickets by the fall, but he says the IT department must complete the software upgrade before that can happen. Casey Roebuck, 2 News, works for you.